Thank you for joining me. Today we are going to see how to import data into Power BI. What is Power BI? It's a great analytical tool. Most of it is free. All that you have to do is go to powerbi.microsoft.com, click on the download button, choose Power BI desktop. Of course, you have to log in using a corporate email ID. Gmail, Hotmail IDs will not work. And then it'll go to Windows Store and then it'll download and install Power BI. Having done that, we create the dashboards on desktop using Power BI desktop. And then you can publish it to Power BI service and share it with other people. That is the part which requires paid service. Whatever we are doing on Power BI desktop is free. The process is like this. You connect to the data, which is what we'll focus on in today's session. And then in further sessions, we'll see how to clean up, import, create reports, and publish them. So here is a quick preview of the process. We will see it across multiple sessions, but here is a quick one. I have the raw data in Excel. I go to Power BI desktop, connect to Excel, choose the table. Notice the table name here is transactions. Get the data in, and then I can create a dashboard. This dashboard is interactive. So if I click anywhere, it's a filter. Everything else gets filtered. So now I am filtering on fuel. Now I'm filtering on a state, Uttar Pradesh, and so on and so forth. This is just a quick review of the whole life cycle. Now, how do you choose data sources? There are two ways of doing it. One is what we do on the desktop, which is what we'll see today. And there are a lot of sources from where we can import, or you can go to the Power BI service on cloud, and you can also import various types of content or data there. Where is the data stored? When you import data into Power BI desktop, there are two ways of connecting to the data. One is import and one is live link. If you import, the data is inside the PBIX file. And once you publish it, it also sits in the Power BI service. If it is a live link, which is typically for databases, it can be online where your database itself is on cloud, or it can be on premise within your company, in which case you have to use something called a data gateway. Once the data comes inside Power BI, it is visible to you in data tab. So Power BI has three tabs. This is the data tab. This is the reports tab where we create reports. And this is relationships. All this we'll see in future videos. So sometimes you need to log in to get the data. For example, if it's a database, you may need to log in. If it's a CSV file, no login. So Power BI is capable of remembering all your logins. Logins can be a complex thing. If you're not a technical person, don't worry about it. But if your IT gives you access to some kind of data, they will tell you what type of login is required. I'm not going to go into details of all these logins, but these are all the possible ways in which you can connect to data, and all of them are supported. So let's look at where can we import data from, and that's most important. The most common, of course, is files. And amongst files, most common files are Excel and CSV. But that's not all. It can get complex very quickly. For example, it's not one CSV. There are 20 CSV files lying in a folder. I don't want to waste time importing each CSV or copy pasting it manually. So that's why we have a folder option. So inside the folder, there could be one or more CSVs or one or more Excel files as well. That's very nice. It saves you a lot of time. One of the other very nice features of Power BI is it can even allow you to import tabular data from a PDF file. To my knowledge, no other tool gives you this facility. I'm sure you have struggled to do this manually, but this is very quickly done using Power BI. Databases, of course, You may not have access to all databases, but if IT has given you a username password, then rather than exporting data to Excel or CSV, it's better to pick it up from a database or a data warehouse. It's not only Microsoft, lots and lots of commonly used databases are supported. And all these connectors are out of the box. You don't pay anything for the connection. Then Power BI itself has data in it. So if you already created a Power BI report and you want to use the data which is used by that report, that also can be used. That is called a Power BI data set. If you are using Dynamics set of products, then common data services is also very useful connection. Azure, if you are using Azure, everything in Azure obviously connects to Power BI because both are from Microsoft. But that doesn't mean it's only Microsoft connectivity. If you go to online services, you will notice that there are many options which are not Microsoft. These are also common data sources and all of them are supported, including Google Analytics, Salesforce, SAP, and so on. As though this is not enough, there is one more category called Other. One of the most powerful ones here is a web page from where you typically copy paste data. Now you can give a URL of the web page and import data without manual work. If there are databases or websites or business applications, nowadays the most popular way of exporting data is oData. Now let's say you have some very arcane old database, nothing special available, at least it'll have an ODBC or OLEDB connected. So practically any database in the world, you should be able to connect and import data into Power BI. Now, once you connect to a data source, whether it is Excel or a web page or a PDF file, there could be multiple pieces of data in it. In Excel, we have sheets, but it's better to have tables. So multiple tables, you choose what you want. Similarly, on a web page, there could be multiple tables. Same way, in a PDF file, there could be multiple tables. In fact, it understands that the same page has two tables. So when you click on it, it'll show you a preview and you choose the pieces of data which you want. So the process of selecting exactly which data you want from a source is done through this guy called Navigator. Now look at this page. This is Google Play. It's a web page, but there is no tabular data. But Power BI is so smart, even if it is not a tabular kind of data, all this data it knows how to pick up. For example, look at this. There is a name, there's a price, and there is a discounted price. And notice what happened. It actually picked up all those columns without any copy paste, without any programming. So importing data into Power BI is really, really powerful, and it saves you a lot of trouble. In some rare cases, very small amount of data which doesn't change very often, you can even enter directly. So you just go to create table inside Power BI and just type what you want. If similar data was in Excel and one time you just want to put it in Power BI, you could also copy paste here. Once you get the data from the source, all the data which you get may not be trouble free. It may have some defects. For example, sometimes there are no headers, or some rows may be duplicate, some rows are empty, some dates are seen as text, text is seen as number, all kinds of things can go wrong. In this session, we are just talking about getting the data in, but obviously, commonly, you need to do some kind of cleanup before we can analyze. That cleanup is done using this button called Transform, and that is what we are going to cover in the next video. So Power BI is versatile in terms of connecting to hundreds of data sources, and it's equally good, equally powerful for cleaning up data as well. Now, all these data sources, most of them are free. For example, if you have SAP, then the connector is free. SAP you have to pay for. If you have SurveyMonkey, then SurveyMonkey subscription you have to pay for, but connecting the data to Power BI is free. In some cases, some people sell data, so they may charge you some amount. Maybe they give some amount free and larger data they charge for it. Or some really exclusive data may be paid. It's on a case-to-case basis, but by and large, whatever I've shown, the connection and the data import is free. So that is what we saw today, connecting to data source. Now in the next series of videos, we are going to go into much more detail into how to clean up the data, because connecting to data source is just one part. Unless you clean it up, you can't really import it and then create the dashboards. So that's what we will see in the upcoming series. Thank you for joining. As you know, I have been working in this industry for a long time. This is a quick introduction. If you like what you saw, you know what to do. Subscribe, click on the bell, and share. So that's it for now. Thank you. Hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.